Arlene Foster, thank you so much for joining Surveillance. What does the Prime Minister, in your eyes, need to do to win your support in the House of Commons vote on Brexit?
Well, good morning. It's very good to be with you. The deal that has come forward from Europe is not a deal that the Democratic Unionist Party can support because it makes a difference between Northern Ireland and the rest of the United Kingdom by the backstop that has been inserted in the deal. There are many good parts in the deal, such as the recognition of European citizens' rights, the fact that we have mutual recognition of professional qualifications. But the backstop, as far as we are concerned, cannot allow us to support this deal, and therefore the backstop must go.
Okay, but there's a suggestion that the Prime Minister would agree to a common rule book between the UK and the EU, Arlene Foster, that might be enough to actually avoid barriers between Northern Ireland and the rest of the UK. Would such a unilateral declaration be enough for you?
Well, see, the difficulty for us in Northern Ireland is that this withdrawal agreement, if it's accepted by Parliament, and of course there's no evidence that it will be accepted by Parliament, would bring into place a legally binding international treaty, which is then in law and is there in black and white and cannot be superseded. Our difficulty is that the political declarations that are being talked about are aspirational. They are not legally binding. And therefore, there is a real asymmetrical relationship between those two documents.
Right, so I understand from what you're saying, or I'm inferring, and correct me if I'm wrong, that a unilateral declaration would not be good enough for you.
We want to hear what the Prime Minister has to say, and we welcome her to this part of the United Kingdom. But we will be saying very clearly to her that she needs to get rid of the backstop. You know, this is going to be a waste of time today if she doesn't listen to what people have to say to her. And as far as I can see, this is not going through Parliament. And therefore, instead of wasting time over this next 2 weeks going on a PR offensive around her deal, what she should be doing is to try and find a third way forward, a deal that finds support in Parliament and a deal that will work. So we're saying to her, don't waste the time. Use that time profitably and try to find a better deal.
Right, but the UK government is telling us that there's no point in reopening talks because they won't budge on the backstop.
Well, you know, they would say that, wouldn't they? I mean, of course people are going to hold to their line until something else has to be done. And they believe that this is the best way forward. But Parliament is going to tell her something very different.
Okay, the DUP has already abstained in important votes on government business. How likely is that to continue?
Well, this deal, as I understand, is coming to Parliament next week for debate and then will be voted on the Tuesday, the 11th of December. As it currently stands, we will not be supporting this deal, and that is the case for many across the chamber, whether they are Remain voters or Leave voters. They are not going to support this deal, and therefore the Prime Minister is not going to get this deal through. So instead of wasting her time, she should actually be trying to find a way that is acceptable to everybody.
Okay, I was talking to Nicky Morgan of the Treasury Select Committee yesterday, and she was saying it's a 50-50 chance that actually we have a hard Brexit. If this deal does not get through, what do you think is the probability of a crashing out?
Well, I think people are wanting to portray this as a binary choice between this deal and no deal. And, of course, the Prime Minister wants to portray it as that because that's the best chance of her getting the deal through. We don't accept that that's the case. We say that there is a third way, a better way, a way that will get the support of the British people through their parliamentarians. And we should be looking for that way now instead of wasting time on a deal that's not going to get support.
Okay, Arlene Foster, a lot of people think that the DUP is bluffing, right? That you will end up, you know, supporting this deal because you fear fresh elections and Jeremy Corbyn coming in, or that you will support the deal in exchange for more money. Are you bluffing?
That's quite offensive, actually, to say that we are going to not vote against it. We are going to support this deal if we were given money for Northern Ireland. That's not what this is about. This is about the future of Northern Ireland constitutionally and economically. And therefore, we will not be supporting the deal in its current format. And by the way, if it is voted down in Parliament, that does not mean a general election, because what we have at the moment is a fixed-term Parliament Act, and it's only when Parliament votes for a general election that it happens. So that's a false thing to say, and it is quite offensive to say that we're bluffing and that we're only holding out for money. Nothing could be further from the truth.
Arlene Foster, how do you see it? So if you think that this deal will be voted down, does then the Prime Minister go back to the EU and get a better deal and then it gets through Parliament the second time? Or, you know, what happens after December 11th?
Well, we would much prefer if she looked for a better deal now instead of wasting the next 2 weeks on a PR offensive. We think that that would be time much better spent trying to find a better way forward and getting rid of that Irish backstop. Because, of course, the only reason the Irish backstop is in, we are told, is because it's there to prevent a hard border on the island of Ireland. But Leo Varadkar, the Irish Prime Minister, has said he's not going to put up a hard border. Europe says they're not going to put up a hard border. It's very strange to know who's going to put this hard border up on the island of Ireland. So we have over hundreds of pages dealing with an Irish backstop that frankly isn't needed.
But have you heard any indication from the government or Theresa May that she is willing to go back to Brussels before December 11th? And if not, what happens on December 12th?
No, I haven't. She is determined to proceed with her deal. She believes that her deal is the best way forward. But clearly she's not listening because Parliament was very clear yesterday when she came to the floor of the House of Commons that she doesn't have the support to get this deal through.